What I have here is a Sony TC-580 open reel tape recorder. I have it partially disassembled so that I can rebuild the braking system. I just refurbished the left side and I still have the right side to go, but here you can see a difference between what good brake pads look like and what bad brake pads look like. I'm going to push the stop button and you will see that the left reel comes to a stop and the right reel keeps spinning or spools loosely. Here we go. You saw that? This here is loose because the brake shoes aren't biting onto the take-up table. And here I can feel some friction. And the brake shoes on this machine is actuated by a solenoid. So when you hit the stop button, there's some springs back there. It shoots out and puts pressure on the brake pads and stops the reels from turning. And this is a bi-directional machine, so it can play in both directions. So if you are playing in this direction, the drive motor behind this reel creates tension on this side, and then the brake on this side is engaged to maintain tape pressure along the heads here. And if you play in that direction, the opposite happens. The drive motor will pull and the brake system here will create drag on this side. So anyway, I'm going to get back to rebuilding the brake on the right side, and hopefully we'll have a nice running machine when I'm done. I used this trimming knife, X-Acto knife, and I scraped off the old brake pad, and then I cut some of this is a wool felt padding. I bought this thickness and this one here, which is way too thick. I wasn't sure how much of a gap there was between the take-up table and the brake shoe, so when I was at the store, I just grabbed both. I could probably use that for something else, you know, put it under a chair or something. This stuff is doing the trick. And I'm not sure about its longevity. I'm not sure how long it'll last inside the tape recorder, but I have this entire sheet. I cut this. This is a leftover piece from the left side that I did. And I still have this remaining sheet here, and then I also have a second sheet. So if this braking material, brake pad material, wears out fast, I can just open it up again and service it again. It's an inexpensive way to rebuild or redo your brake pads in your tape recorder. So it beats hunting the internet for old dried out parts that probably wouldn't work anyway. So I'm gonna get to it. I'm gonna rebuild this thing and I'm gonna put it back in the machine, and hopefully I'll have a proper running open reel tape recorder. Okay, I'm using my flashlight here to help illuminate this. I got the brake pad replaced on both sides now, and the reels are now stopping without the tape spilling out in play mode. So if I go here to play mode, or let's, so there, it's turning. Now if I hit stop, the tape doesn't spill out. You know, just the guides here releases the pressure, and but I don't have the reels dumping tape like that, so that's nice. And also, when I was earlier, I was doing a test. I was going into I was testing fast forward and rewind. Now, if I let this go all the way to the end, it works now, but let me just, oh, another thing I had to live with now is, if I hit stop, the tape will spill out, but not as much as before, but to compensate for that, what I do is I just reverse the direction first, wait for it to slow down, and then hit stop. And I can live with that. I used to do that on Pro Decks when I did my internship at a recording studio. They had the same issue with, 16-track decks. But what I was... let me demonstrate it here now. I'm going to rewind this all the way back. And as I was doing my test, I noticed that it was going slow. And then as it got closer to the end here, it really started slowing down, and the new brakes I put in were creating too much friction. And so what I had to do to compensate for that was this mechanism right here. Notice if I push that up, it releases the brakes and it also engages the reverse motor. But what I did here is I added some of this gaffer's tape. I put a strip and I wrapped it around there. And what that does is when it lifts the brakes, it lifts it off the tables a little more, so there's not so much drag whenever it's in a fast forward or rewind. And that allows the tape to go all the way to the end. So that solved that problem. But again, like I said before, the issue of fast forward and rewind and hitting stop in mid-flight still makes the tape spill out. I don't have a manual for this machine, but I have a distinct feeling that that the same thing happened when this machine was brand new, just by looking at the way the mechanisms are, or the way the brake system is set up, that that you have to slow down the mode before you go into stop. So if you were in fast rewind, before you hit stop, you have to go fast forward then stop. So like I said before, I had to do that on professional decks when I was doing an internship at a recording studio. So I see no problem with that, and I'm considering the brake job on this machine done. So yeah, so now I'm just going to button up all the covers. I need to tighten the Allen bolts. I don't know if you could see down in here, but, oh yeah, maybe you can. There's some Allen bolts that are holding the tables onto the motor spindles, and I have to tighten those down. They're still sitting on there loose, so yeah, I got to tighten that up so that the spindles don't eventually work their way off. I mean the tables work their way off the spindles. So yeah, that's the next thing. Okay, here is the Sony TC-580 all buttoned up. And I temporarily have it hooked up to that little amplifier up there. And let's have a listen. This audio was previously recorded on a different machine, so You notice that the record meters are displaying different volume levels, and that's because the other machine, it had some circuitry issues. As you see, if I hit the button here, we won't get any tape spillage. See how the both wheels stopped? They didn't continue on, like if it was playing this direction. This reel didn't continue to dump its tape. It came to a good stop. So my brake pad solution was a success. And earlier I had added an additional piece of gaffer's tape on the solenoid lifter to relieve the brake pressure during fast forward and rewind. So now if I hit rewind, before I added that modification, about now the tape would start slowing down because there would be too much brake pressure and it wouldn't finish rewinding all the way. But now it always seems that duct tape or gaffer's tape always comes to the rescue on these kinds of issues. But yeah, it works. And prior to upgrading or refurbishing the brake pads, when this came to a stop, or when the tape ran out, both reels would have just kept spinning. They wouldn't have stopped. It would take about probably 20 seconds for both reels to come to a rest. Well, the one with tape would slow down faster, and this one here, we would just keep going. You see, even if I push it with my finger, it stops. Prior to the brake upgrade / restoration refurbishing, if I'd done that, it would just keep spinning, keep going and going and going. But yeah, so there it is, functioning nicely, the Sony TC-580.